Hi, Travis from POSkies.com. Today we're going to follow up our review of the Datalogic Heron 3430-3100 series. This is the color changing model of their retail barcode scanner. I'm going to show you how to do it in two ways. One is the fancy multi-color changing ways. So if you notice, this barcode scanner here is going red, white, and blue. It's alternating between the two. Every couple of seconds, it's changing to the next color in the series. And this is our solid color scanner. So right now, it's a solid green. And to change it, it's really easy. There is a color change barcode sheet that's available on our website. I'll put a link right here. Maybe it's right here. And just download that data sheet. And what you're gonna have on it is the ability to turn off colors altogether. So I'll disable all the colors. Then when you scan, it'll still light up the side when you get a good scan, but besides that, it'll stay dark. We'll turn it on, and then we'll pick another solid color. So it's green right now. I'll switch to blue. You just scan the blue barcode, and now it'll stay blue. If you want like pink, you pick pink, and then it becomes a solid pink. Or if you want like, let's pick yellow. And then you got yellow. So there's 9 solid colors that you can pick from. In order to do something a little fancier, you can select random pattern and it'll alternate between those 9 colors. It starts with red and then every couple of seconds it's gonna cycle into the next color. So that's your easy to change color option. To do more advanced programming, we're gonna go over to the computer and I'll show you how to use the Datalogic Aladdin software to configure a series of colors.
Okay, we're over here on the desktop and I have the Datalogic Aladdin software running. If you need it, visit POSguys.com, go to the Datalogic Heron product, and in the download section you can download the Aladdin software. What we're going to do right now is first put the scanner into USB COM mode. So on our website as well, there's a little barcode here for USB COM. You're going to need to scan that first. And then in Aladdin, you can go to search for one device. And it should find it on one of your COM ports. And it sets like the default variables. Additionally, if you do search on connection, you'll see this barcode on the screen. You scan that barcode with your scanner. And then it'll also auto detect it. And you can click this button here, click to configure. And it will set it up. So it's reading the values on the device right now. I've configured this scanner for red, white, and blue. Other than that, it's pretty much at defaults. So here in the tab, you're going to see RGB LED settings. If you come in and everything's closed, you go to reading parameters, and then go to RGB LED settings. Okay, the easy settings to do are select one of the colors from the list. That's the easy thing to do there. If you select one of those, then you have a solid color. But if you want to do a custom pattern, you're going to click this button that says Set Color Pattern. So when you click that, you open up this little grid diagram here that shows it. So what you're seeing right here is red is being displayed for 2 seconds, then white is being displayed for 3 seconds, then blue is being displayed for 3 seconds, then it loops back to the beginning and it does it again. These arrows right here are your transition times, so it's 2 seconds to white, 1 second to blue, 2 seconds to red. If I delete this, we can start all over from the beginning. So you come in as blank. You click Add, and you're going to get this interface here for picking a color. Here's some nice swatches. It appears that it can do any color, but some of the colors are going to be pretty similar. If you pick like this pink and this pink, when you look at your scanner, you're probably going to see the same pink. It's not so precise that it can show any color that you want, but it definitely will do a pink, a red, a orange, a yellow. Those will be distinctive. So the first thing you're going to do is select your color. You can select from the swatch. You can also select from kind of this default Windows selector for colors. You can also put in RGB value. So if you're doing like a school store or something and you know the RGB values for your color, you can just kind of play with these sliders and get it. So I'm going to go back to swatches and I'm going to pick a blue. So when you look down here, it's all in milliseconds here. Your transition time in this node, this is how long it's going to take to switch to this color. A 10 value here is going to switch very fast. If you put 1,000 in, that's basically 1 second. 2 seconds is actually kind of nice, then it transitions slowly. Okay, your holding time is how long you're going to stay at that color. You can have a max here of 160 seconds. I'm going to do 4,000, so we're going to have 4 seconds on blue. This back two right now is grayed out since we don't have any other color selected. So I'm going to say OK. There's my first color. I'm going to add one more. This time I'm going to use the RGB selector and I'm going to do white. White is a maximum value for all colors. My transition time, we're going to stay on this color for, or we're going to transition to this color in 2 seconds. And we're going to hold white for 4 seconds. So what I'm going to do now is set a back to color. So we're going to select color one. And then you can select how many times I want to loop. I want to do infinite. So we're just going to rotate between blue, white, blue, white, blue, white, an infinite amount of times. If you just want to kind of do it once, you select once, and you can go up to 14 times or infinite. You say OK. And so I have my little diagram here of what I want to do. You can add up to 5 colors. And then once you're ready, you hit write configuration. So it now loads it up to the barcode scanner. And once it's done, we can close this window and disconnect our scanner. You click close. And then right up here is the disconnect scanner. And if you click that, then the scanner resets. And now it's flashing between blue and white. If you need to edit it some more, you can click the connect to device. You scan the barcode on the screen again, or if it finds it by itself, you just click to configure. And then it'll get the values from the scanner and you can once again configure it. So that's the Aladdin software in a nutshell for changing the color. You can do a lot of other things in here. If you want to load custom sounds, then that's in it as well. It's under audio settings. You have to upload the tones into the scanner and then you can select which ones you want to use. There's also the ability to do data formatting. So if you want to do certain pattern matching with it, like strip out zeros out of UPC codes and things like that, then you can do it in here. There's also advanced driver's license parsing. So if you're going to be scanning the back of driver's license and want to get only like the name and address, then you can configure that in here as well. So a very powerful tool. It takes a little while to get used to it, and don't forget to put your device into USB COM mode before trying to use it, or else it's going to infinitely search for your device if it's in USB HID mode. And so that wraps up our color changing video on the Datalogic Heron. For more information on the Heron or to download the utilities, please visit us at posguys.com. Thank you.